A problem we've been having lately is customers buy these lithium iron phosphate batteries, such as the SOK batteries, and they get them, they install them, they think they're like a lead acid battery, and they arrive 100% full. They hook them all up, turn on some loads, and run them completely dead, and then say the battery died after just one cycle, and now they can't get it to work, and it won't take a charge. Well, let me show you what's going on here. This battery is actually a return from an Amazon customer that did exactly that. If I measure the voltage here on these terminals with my meter, you see I just have a fraction of a volt. It's effectively 0 volts. So this battery is completely dead. Now, the problem is they use chargers like this one I have over here. This is an Ames 75 amp charger converter. And I'm gonna hook this up to the battery. Now, this charger is already plugged into AC power. So let's just connect it on real quick with this Anderson connector. And now I'm gonna turn on the power switch here. Now if we look on the other side, there's some lights and stuff, and none of these lights are coming on, the charger's not kicking on. And in this case, the customer actually said the battery won't take a charge, they blame the battery. Now, there's nothing wrong with the battery. If I measure on the terminals of this charger though, you see I have 0 volts effectively. And this charger requires voltage on its input because it's auto-selecting between 12 and 24 volts, and it doesn't know what to do because it sees 0 volts. It doesn't know what mode to go into, so it can't turn on because it doesn't see battery voltage. So there's a couple ways to get out of this situation. And by the way, this is very common too with inverter chargers, that they need power on their terminals in order to kick on and run their charger. So one way, if you have an adjustable power supply like this, you can set it to about 14 volts. And the current, I have set at 10 amps, but since the clips aren't connected, there's no current flowing. Simply just connect the charger or a power supply on. It's gonna act as a charger. And you can see 10 amps flowing into the battery. And any moment now, yep, just now, the Ames charger kicked on, and now the battery is charging. So if I get this out of the way and measure with my meter, you can see now I have 13.5 volts. So the battery is reactivated. And if I turn off the charger and turn it back on, it turns on, no problem, just like before. I could even show you the status light. See, it's working now. Now, let's say you don't have a power supply. You're out in the field, you have this in your RV, you need to get it up and running again. Something very simple that can act like a power supply is any other battery that's between about, I would say about 11 volts and about 14.6 volts. Just use jumper cables, jump start it like a car, you know, following the proper procedure. Anything to get voltage on the terminals of your charger or inverter that can then allow it to kick on, start charging, and as soon as the battery sees current flowing into it, it'll wake back up, it'll work like normal, and accept a charge. And that's it. I mean, it's pretty straightforward, but not knowing this process as a beginner, it can be kind of scary, I understand, but all it takes is charge current to reactivate a battery at 0 volts. Now, let's say you try all this and it doesn't work. A quick check on these SOK batteries, at least, they're user serviceable. There's 10 screws around the top, and then the cover lifts off. Open it up, do a visual inspection, see if there's any pinched wires or shipping damage, you know. Freak things do happen, it's not unheard of, but always try the simplest thing first. Look inside, see if something's damaged. If not, put it back together, get some charge into it. Now, if you want one of these power supplies right here, they are your friend, they are cheap. We've got them on a link down in the description below. Otherwise, I think that about covers it. This is how to wake back up your completely dead battery, such as the SOK. And you know, this actually applies to Ampere Time, Chins, Battleborn, all the big names. They all function in this exact same way. It's not a problem with the battery. It's a problem with the charger, and it's kind of common. Now, one other thing to mention, the Victron Blue Smart chargers, the IP22 and IP67 chargers, they will wake up a dead battery. They're like the charger and the power supply built in. So that's some really nice functionality. The other one, the Victron Smart Solar Controller, can also charge fully depleted batteries because, you know, the Victron products are just a super nice quality and they've thought these things through, so they've built their product to handle it better. So anyway, hope that helps. If you guys like this, please subscribe to the channel and leave a thumbs up. Other than that, comment any questions you may have, and I hope today we helped you have a better day.